You are welcome to the Visionary Business Project Classroom. This is where we use the Word of God to teach practical success principles for your business development and personal development. Now, what I have for you today is what I call, where is your bosom? Where is your bosom? I'm sure, don't worry, you will understand what I mean by this title after the end of this teaching. Now, I want you to look at this quote. You won't fully maximize the benefits of your giving if you have no bosom to receive it. You won't fully maximize the benefits of your giving if you have no bosom to receive it. Now, the Lord opened my eyes to see this at a particular stage in my life and my ministry and the organization that I run. Now, I want you to look at this Bible passage. I'll be reading from the book of Luke, chapter 6, verse 38. Luke, chapter 6, verse 38. This is Jesus talking. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be put into your bosom. You can see that word coming up. Now, for with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. Now, it's so clear, Jesus was showing a principle here. That is the principle of sowing and harvesting. The principle of giving and getting back in return, which is a very stable principle, a very popular principle in the Bible. Now, I want you to look at the diagrams, the boxes that I have on the board. Box A has what I call give. Remember, Jesus started with give, and it shall be given unto you. Give. Now, what do I mean by give? I'm not just talking about the giving of money or the giving of money resources out. Under this box, we can have things like the way you give out your talent to help others, the way you deploy your skills to solve problems of others, what you give to the poor, what you give to Christian ministries that are truly doing the will of God, what you give to Christian ministers that are truly doing the will of God. Now, giving is living. The Bible says, as long as this heart remains, seed time and harvest shall not cease. If you are not giving, you are not living. So Jesus said, give. Give. In your business, what are you giving out? In your personal life, what are you giving out? Now, let us go to the second box. In the second box, Jesus said, it shall be given unto you. He said, give, and it shall be given unto you. So, what does it mean? It means it is sure. Just like I said, it's a principle. When you give, it will be given back to you. It is Jesus saying this, and it's a principle that is so sure. Now, let us go to the third box, box C, where Jesus says something about good measure, pressed down, shaking together. Now, what does this mean? Because when you give and it is given back to you, third box is making you to understand that what you get back in return will always be greater than what you have given under box A. It is a principle. He said, good measure, if you give out quality, good measure, the same quality will be given back to you. He said, pressed down and shaken together. That is, the harvest will always be greater than the seeds you have sown. It is a principle and it is so sure. So, I always advise people, you must always live your life giving out what you have to solve the problems of others, to help others. Just like I said, giving is living, because the harvest will always be greater than what you have sown. Now, I want you to look at this box, box D. Very, very important. I want you to note this. Jesus says something that is also very important. When you give out quality, to solve the problems of men. Jesus is saying, men, we also give back to you. Now, the good measure, pressed down, shaken together, we always come from the same men that you have sown into. Now, he said, men will give to you. You have solved the problems of men, then you should expect men to give back to you. Just like I said, it is a sure measure. Now, let me go back, let me now come to the box, the next box, which is a very, very important box concerning this particular topic. Just like I said at the beginning, I said you will understand what I mean by bosom at the end of this teaching. Now, you need to catch this now. It's very important. Jesus said, men will give back to you. Men will give to your bosom. What do I mean by bosom? Now, this is where a lot of people miss this, especially Christians. So many Christians have been givers. They give in church. They give concerning the gospel of Jesus Christ. They give to ministers of the gospel. So many of them have been working, giving out their time, working in churches for so many years. They've been very dedicated. But there is always a problem. And what is that problem? That problem is the issue of non-availability of a bosom on their part. Because Jesus is saying, men will give to what? Bring to your bosom. Now, let me now practically explain to you what I mean by a bosom. Now, you need to create a platform where you can receive back what you have sown. What are those platforms? The platform can be a business. The platform can be the work that you do. The platform can be your NGO. There must be something. There must be a platform that men will be able to bring your harvest to you. This is very important. If you have been giving in church, if you have been serving in church, if you have been helping others, and you sit down at home, you are not working. How can men bring the harvest to you? That will be very impossible. And there is nothing God can do about it. Some people go to another level by creating a business platform whereby the harvest can be able to interact with them. So, if you have been a giver all this while, and you are wondering, how come the harvest is not coming? The harvest are lying in the spiritual realm. Now, it is now your turn to create an organized platform, a business, get a job, and be very dedicated, and be very diligent, start an NGO, have a platform, an organized platform, where your harvest can be able to come to you or interact with you. I believe you have been blessed by this teaching. I want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I also want you to follow me on Twitter at Teaching Apostle. I believe you will be part of the next class of the Visionary Business Project. Thank you very much.